One of the greatest successes of 2008 is the citywide recycling program. Citizen participation is much higher than anticipated, which makes the city, residents, and our recycling partners happy. That's why Pratt Industries decided to build a MRF, or Material Recovery Facility, right here to handle the recyclables. What is a MRF and what does it do? We thought you'd like to know, so we spent some time there getting the answers.
You're at the new Pratt Recycling Facility located here in Fayetteville. We're still in the preliminary stages. We're just starting. We're running a bunch of test commodities to make sure the equipment is running correctly. There's still a good deal of time yet before we're fully operational. But it's important with all the equipment that you're getting ready to see that it is running properly. So we've brought in just minimal amounts of material to test everything that's been brought in. It's called a MRF, Material Recovery Facility. And we bring in, all we do here is we bring in everything that's put on the curbside or at the local community recycling facilities. And it's all, and we sort it out. At the end of it, we want to have paper, we want to have different types of plastics all sorted out so that they can be used to make additional products of whatever they may be. If you can see in the background here, we have paper, which will go to our mill near Atlanta, Georgia, that will be used to make more cardboard. Pratt Industries is the sixth largest manufacturer of cardboard and packaging products in the country. So this material is going to be used to make more product here in the United States. We'll recycle the milk jugs, will be used to make more milk jugs, the clear drink bottles, which could be Pepsi and your Coca-Cola that you get at the local grocery store, might be sold to places back to Coca-Cola or Pepsi for more plastic bottling. Aluminum might go to places like Anheuser-Busch. Steel will go into making more steel cans. So all of it will be used to, hence the name recycle, will be used again. It gets dumped, and you'll see some of this equipment, but the material is dumped. It runs through a lot of equipment. We have fancy names like Trommels, which is very similar to your washer or your dryer at home. You'll see a sort line. You'll see a bounce belt where material, where we separate plastic and paper. And all of it is used, again, just to separate all of the material. Our goal is to separate all of this out so that we can manufacture more. Some of the critical, and the reasons why we do this, water is always in short supply these days. Water is a major issue, and people think about it's good to recycle the material, but one of the benefits is when we use recycled material, the amount of water that is saved, and we use a lot less water, a lot less electricity, it really is a benefit. As the country goes green, this is a major part of it, saving as much water as we can, and this is a great way to do it. Well, here, we're just in a preparatory stage of shipping the material out. This is the very end of the process. I don't know if you can see over my shoulder or not, but the material has been, I call it squished. It's been put into a big baler, and the material is baled and ready to be put on the truck. Each one of these trucks will carry 20 tons. A ton is 2,000 pounds. So the truck will carry 40,000 pounds of material. That's how much this machinery will squish the material together. The materials that are accepted, you can find on the blue bin that is on your household, but cardboard, newspaper, milk jugs, drink bottles, laundry detergent bottles. Those are the 99% of the items that you will have in your household that are accepted. And again, you can always check the top of your bin. And remember, plastic bags are not accepted at the curbside. Pratt Recycling, US-wide, we recycle over 720,000 tons of material every year. That's like taking 360,000 cars off of the road for 12 months. So every bit helps. It's important for the citizens that you do this, and it's we never recycle enough, and we can always do more, but every little bit helps. The reason that we don't ask citizens to separate their recyclables is that economically, for the city and for us, it's just more viable that the material be sorted here. The trucks that would be on the curbside have to be much different. They're much more expensive. The automation to get all of that on those individual trucks is past the capacity and the expenditure for the city. Whereas if you bring all the material in at once, we can have one sort here done, and it just becomes more economical for the city and for everyone involved. Recycling is a very easy project. This is not a Democratic, and we've just been in an election, it's not a Republican issue. This is something that every citizen can do. It is so easy. It just requires you to take your bin out to the curb. It's one of the few things you can do that will save water, that will save electricity, and really goes a long way to helping our planet become more green for the future. This really is an easy thing for all citizens to participate in.